Good morning. Today we are going to learn determination of calorific value of a given sample of fuel by using bomb calorimeter equipment from a topic fuel. This is the learning outcome for today's session. At the end of this session, students will be able to describe determination of calorific value of a fuel by using bomb calorimeter. This is the content we are going to learn in this session. First, we will learn the diagram of a bomb calorimeter equipment. Then we will learn the construction and working of bomb calorimeter. Then observations of the experiment. And with the help of observation, how to derive the equations to calculate higher calorific value and lower calorific value of a given sample of fuel. So this is the diagram of a bomb calorimeter equipment. If you see here, the bomb calorimeter total equipment consists of different components, but the main component is, this one is a stainless steel bomb, which is divided into two parts. One is a stainless steel body and second one is a lead. The lead is having a provision of two electrodes. These two electrodes are connected with a wire and that we have to connect to the battery while working. To the lower end of these two electrodes, there is a provision of hanging a crucible inside which we are taking a unit mass of the fuel for combustion. Then to the lead, there is a provision of safety release valve, which is mainly designed to maintain the safety during the experiment. Then the total stainless steel bomb is inserted into a copper calorimeter. This one is a copper calorimeter which is filled with the water, and inside the water it is inserted. The water consists of one thermometer which is used to record the temperature of water before combustion of a fuel and after combustion of fuel. And one more mechanical stirrer is there, and the purpose of the mechanical stirrer is to rotate the water for the purpose of uniformly absorbing the heat evolved by the combustion of fuel. The copper calorimeter is properly insulated with an air jacket and water jacket, and the purpose of these two insulating jackets is to avoid the loss of heat by radiation. So this is the diagram of bomb calorimeter equipment that we are using to find out the calorific value of a given sample of fuel. This apparatus is used to find out the calorific value of particularly solid and non-volatile type of liquid fuels. How it is constructed, just now I explained. It is constructed with a strong cylindrical stainless steel bomb in which the combustion of fuel is made. The bomb is having a lead which can be tightly stoppered, and then it is inserted into a copper calorimeter which is filled with the water. The water consists of the thermometer as well as the mechanical stirrer. Thermometer is used to record the change in temperature of water. So here I would like to ask you one question. Bomb calorimeter is used for determination of calorific value of option A, solid fuel, option B, non-volatile liquid fuel, option C, gaseous fuel, and option D, both A and B. So the question is that ki bomb calorimeter is used for determination of which type of fuel. Think for a moment. The correct answer is option D, that is both A and B. Therefore, the bomb calorimeter is used for determination of solid as well as non-volatile liquid fuel. So the correct answer is option D, both A and B. Now how it works? A known mass of 0.5 to 1 gram of the fuel is taken in a clean crucible. The crucible is then supported over the ring. A fine magnesium wire is then stretched across the electrodes and the bomb lead is tightly stoppered. Then the bomb is totally inserted into a copper calorimeter filled with water. The initial temperature of the water is recorded. The electrodes are then connected to 6-volt battery and the circuit is completed. The sample gets burned and heat is liberated. The evolved heat is allowed to absorb in a water. So these are the observations of the bomb calorimeter experiment. Mass of fuel sample taken in crucible is X gram. Mass of water taken in calorimeter is capital W gram. Water equivalent due to calorimeter, stirrer, thermometer, etc. is small W gram. Temperature of water before combustion, T1 degree centigrade. Temperature of water after combustion, T2 degree centigrade. And higher calorific value is L. So these are the observations we have recorded while we are carrying out the experiment. We know the how much amount of the fuel taken, that is noted by X. How much water we have taken in copper calorimeter, capital W. And how much water is replaced, that is small W. T1 is the temperature of water before combustion and T2 is the temperature of water after combustion and L is HCV. Now for this experiment, there are three corrections. The first correction is acid value correction, which is noted as AC. Every fuel sample consists the elements like sulfur, nitrogen, and therefore these elements during combustion gets converted to corresponding acidic gases. As the reaction itself is an example of exothermic reaction, it adds the heat. Therefore, that particular amount of heat should be subtracted from the total amount of heat. Now, second correction is fuse wire correction, which is noted as FC. We know that the platinum or magnesium wire is used for the combustion of fuel. And because of heating of wire, it adds heat. Therefore, that amount of heat should be subtracted from the total amount of heat. So these two corrections we have to subtract from the total amount of heat because this particular heat is not we are getting from the carbon from a fuel sample, but we are getting from elements like sulfur, nitrogen or the wire. Therefore, that particular amount of the heat we have to subtract from the total amount of the heat. Now this is the third correction known as cooling correction. Some of the heat get condensed because of local cooling due to stainless steel bomb apparatus. Therefore, some amount of heat is not measured by the thermometer. Therefore, that particular amount of heat should be added to the total amount of heat. So out of three correction, acid value correction, fuse wire correction should be subtracted. And cooling correction should be added. So now with the help of observation and corrections, we will derive the equations for HCV and LCV. Now, what is the statement? Heat liberated is equal to. So always heat liberated is a product of LX. So what is L? L is HCV. And what is HCV? The capacity of the fuel to supply the heat. Multiplied by what is the amount of fuel we have taken for the experiment. So heat liberated is equal to LX. Heat absorbed is equal to W plus W into another bracket T2 minus T1. Then what happened? Okay, the third statement is that heat liberated is always equal to heat absorbed. So whatever the total amount of heat is getting liberated, all the heat will be absorbed in a water sample. Therefore, LX is equal to W plus W into another bracket T2 minus T1. Now how to calculate HCV? HCV is equal to W plus W into another bracket T2 minus T1 divided by X. The unit is calorie per gram. So we know that capital W is a mass of water taken in calorimeter. Small W is a water equivalent. T2 is a temperature of water after combustion and T1 is a temperature of water before combustion and X is the amount of fuel taken. So in this way we can calculate the higher calorific value of a given sample of fuel. But to the same equation we have to apply the corrections and then the corrected HCV equation becomes W plus W into bracket T2 minus T1 plus CC. Because we have learned that one correction, particularly cooling correction, should be added. minus AC plus FC divided by X, and the unit is calorie per gram. Now what about LCV? LCV is lower calorific value. The concept is that the amount of the heat that is available for direct use, because from HCV, certain amount of the heat we are allowing to escape into atmosphere. Practically, we cannot condense that particular heat, and therefore we have to derive the LCV, which is also known as net calorific value. So LCV is equal to HCV minus 0.09 multiplied by percentage of hydrogen multiplied by 587 divided by X. The unit is calorie per gram. One more point I will clear you, ki correction should not be applied separately for LCV, because we are using corrected HCV to find out the LCV. So only one time we have to apply the correction, that also for HCV. Once we get the corrected HCV, we can get directly LCV. So what do you mean by percentage of hydrogen? It means that ki whatever the percentage of hydrogen is present in a given sample of fuel, that we have to consider here. And what is 587? It is the standard latent heat of a steam, because we are allowing to escape certain products of combustion to the atmosphere. Therefore, that factor is 587. So finally, LCV is equal to HCV minus 0.09 multiplied by percentage of hydrogen multiplied by 587 divided by X. The unit is calorie per gram. So all that slides are prepared by using a textbook of engineering chemistry written by Jain and Jain. And even I have added here one reference for the Baum calorimeter diagram. Thank you.